And he turned around and told me that I'm a millionaire and you are not a millionaire. I'm an entrepreneur and you work for me, so you listen to me. In fact, that was very exciting because that was one of turning point in my life. And I told that, okay, I have enough of working for people. Let me take a little bit more risk. And that was my, well, in other words, they say that's what actually break the camel's backbone. And you say that I have enough. And I took an entrepreneurial journey back then. And it's all over the web and so on. In the last 5 years that we started, we got the company listed. Actually, in 2000 working days, we had a countdown server in Masterskill, and we said exactly this is how we're going to do it. And strangely, we achieved it in 1,978 days. So that was a great landmark, an achievement. I said, wow, we did it. But the challenge is after you make it. A lot of people would have spoken how they build it up and so on. Perhaps I've gone through that particular phase, I've shared many times, and I want to share something. The greatest challenge of an entrepreneur is not when you are doing well, not when you are doing 100 million, 200 million profit a year. The greatest challenge is when you get a company listed and you have share price 70 cents. And that's where it's time of reflection. Time of rethink back, wow, this has really hit me a lot. What am I going to do? This is a time of test of real entrepreneurship, real leader. If you are a strong person, you will stay. If you give up, mentally or physically, then you are out. So, let me share this journey of 18th of May 2010. Yes, we got listed, we got one of our largest listing for the first half of 2010 in Southeast Asia, not in Malaysia. Wow, it's great. But the great challenge comes in when the company got listed is you are no longer only controlled by the micro, by a lot of macro that you can no longer control. Anybody outside there can throw a stone and will hit you. It's just a question how painful it is. And no doubt that in a highly regulated environment in higher education, we have the Deputy Minister of Higher Education, my good friend, that the greatest challenge is any decisions done by ministry or regulation will hit you straight. For example, there were changes in PTPTN and so on. We cannot do anything. It's right hitting our bottom line and so on. So as an entrepreneur, perhaps the greatest challenge is rule number one is you accept what it comes to hit you. If you do not accept that this has hit us and we need to change, you will be never able to change. Secondly, we need to have plans. It's like playing chess, you need to have a lot of options. So the challenge here is, rule number two is to compartmentalize your problem. Split the problem, okay, this is a share pricing issue, we park it first, we park in sedan. Okay, we have this particular problem with the ministry, the regulation, changing environment, park it in Kajang first. So as long as we can park all these, and then you say, okay, I have all these nice, beautiful cars, all parked elsewhere, all good problems. If we manage to solve it, then we say which one to solve first. Rule number two. First, I said accept what hits you. You have the plan, you understand. And thirdly, this is something that inbuilt with an entrepreneur, that no matter how big the wave is, it's like tsunami, you know, you cannot run away. You're an entrepreneur. Either you do it or you die. All right? If you think that entrepreneurship is so difficult, then I tell you, sell your business, become a politician. I'm trying to say to become a politician that easy, but at least, you're not accountable for the shareholders and investors who are hunting you like crazy and so on. All right? So, the more important thing that I want to share, the third point, is what I have gone through in these last 2 years. 2010, 20th November, I was having great dinner with the MB Johor and everything, and I was receiving an award. And the same day, after an hour, I had a right brain aneurysm, ruptured aneurysm. Technically, if you have ruptured aneurysm, 99.999%, you are dead already, you know. but you see, God is not ready to accept me to become his advisor yet. So he told me, no, I'm letting you go, you have still got time. And here I come back after 3-4 months, after to have a plate in the head, all the surgery and so on, and I said, okay, I need to do soul searching. What am I going to do? Should I just sell the business? Should I transfer? Should I do that? Should I do this? And I said, no, I'm a born entrepreneur, I'm going to do this. Because the excitement is when the environment is so challenging. Am I right or not? That's what makes you excited. If everything is just same like your way, all doors open, one master key open, 100 doors, nothing great. The excitement is when the policies are against you, when the whole world is against you, all the doors closed, it's okay, you've got window, you crawl through. Yeah, it's not exciting, you get all this, make yourself dirty and so on, you can't wear your suit, but who cares? By end of the day, you still come out stronger. Am I right? So this is what I always tell to a lot of my, whenever I go to the MIC and Indian community, I say, don't complain about all these policies and so on. It has been there, it's going to be there until and when. A lot of time will tell, time will heal, but till then that we have to fight, so you have to crawl. So an entrepreneur, so I thought I came back, let's build a business, we look back, revamp back and so on. And I was doing everything great, and I still remember when I met Sister Eng Eng in Brussels, am I right? That 1 week before going to Brussels, I was told that I won the TOYP. Wow, I was so great, am I right now? Winning CYEA World Award, first Asian, first Malaysian, all right? Before that, it's all European, winning first. Obviously, you know why, like, the Indians always can talk, so we can impress people, obviously, I won. But more than that, when I won the TOYP and Sister Eng Eng was there and so on, and 1 week before that, I just happened to go and do a scan on my head. Just obviously, I went to the hospital, I got nothing to do, waiting for a doctor, and he said, let's scan, since I missed my breakfast and everything. And he said, oh, I've got very bad news for you, you've got another aneurysm on your left-hand side brain. Wow, this is challenging. Am I right or not? But despite all that, I still fly. I still behave like nothing wrong, am I right now? Knowing that 2 weeks from now I had to go for another severe surgery that you may not even come back. Right? So if you compare this back in business world, that's why when I hit all these challenges, I see that it's not life-threatening world. Am I right now? Here's another problem, let's solve it, park it, and let's look at it. Nothing is worse than giving your brain, you know. Go through the entire thing, open up, put a platinum screws, 6 screws. So I got 2 platinum and 6 screws in my head right now. So that has actually tuned me to become better. So coming back into this, these are challenges of life, are life threatening, am I right? Nothing could be worse, you know. What is the use if 100, 200 million if it's gone, nobody could do it, or you become a salvage, you can't speak, you can't talk, or you're in a wheelchair, am I right now? And so, this is a moment of truth, talking to God. So you have to talk to God what you want, and you have to tell that this I have not achieved, I want to achieve this first. And you have to convince God, you know. Otherwise, he said, no, game over. So, a couple of things that I have said. As an entrepreneur, I build Masterskill. Yes, we had good times, we had bad times, now it's a very challenging time. I know in Lawyer Forum, they write everything, like they say that Edmund is the only guy who cheats the Kuala and the Chinese investors. Alright? But whenever I feedback, you know, they never accept, but never mind. But I take it very positively. What I say that we will turn around this company. Education is not something that you can turn around in one day, you know. A nice like airline tomorrow, you give 50% discount, 99 cents, the hit goes up and you sell for next 20 years and you show the profit right now. Education, we can't do that. But having said that, we came out with a lot of new strategy. That to turn around, I said, okay, in education, we will do something very different that nobody did in the world. That we will start up a multi-level marketing. That we call it entrepreneur development program. That we will empower my graduates, empower my alumni. Not only to sell short courses, short programs and so on, we also will sell 20% of futuristic program right now. That means you can block future seats right now as long as you have all the requirements. So a lot of thinking, we'll be the first in the world to do it. And I tell you, in Malaysia, whenever you're the first to do it, the bureaucratic person said, no, it's a sin, you cannot do it. The challenge is, you have to go and evangelize them. We are entrepreneurs. Am I right? I still recall in 2004 when he said we want to start nursing, we want to do 2000. He said, come on, Edmund, you can't do it. Only 50, you can't do it. I'll even cut my ears off. You know, obviously I should go and get the people's ears back. I didn't collect that. That's what I should be doing. So, as an entrepreneur, there's always great challenges. All right? Never give up. Tough time never lasts. Huh? This is the fourth message I said. Tough time never lasts, but tough people do. Proof. Two brain aneurysm and everything never hit me yet. Am I right now? So when I come here, I told Sister Eng that I will speak from different angle. Let the others speak about how to build excitement, you know, not. No doubt, entrepreneurship, successfulness comes with what? When you're successful in doing something, money is a byproduct of success. So you can park one Aston Martin, nice number plate there. Park one Hummer H2 there. Am I right or not? Park an X6M there. Sister Eng, am I right or not? Go there anywhere you like a watch. Oh, 300,000. Oh, no problem. Swipe. You know or not? It comes with that, you know? But likewise, all that also comes with a lot of challenges. It's not easy when you make it up. To climb up is easy. You know, once you are there, you need to maintain. And especially when you've been hit. And this is where I like to share a great person that I respect in my entrepreneurship career is Tan Sri Lee Kim Yew. I have interviewed him in 1998 for my MBA project. Remarkable person. And after that, now I live in Countryside and so on. Obviously, I told my wife when she was studying in UKM that one day I'll buy a property for you here, this plot and so on. So exactly. Just saying you are a witness to that, huh? I exactly buy 3.5 acres, I go 10 acres in country, and practically do that, you know. I fulfill all my words, you know. Am I not? So if I fulfill to my wife, I have to fulfill to my friends and eventually to the shareholders. So the great challenge of an entrepreneur is honor your word as much as you could, unless the God says that 99.9% you can do, but the 0.01% God decide, you know. So when I got this CYEA award in Delhi, and the point of time I didn't know what is JCI all about. I was thinking, I was also doing soul searching. Then I attended two world congress, one in India and one in Tunisia, to understand better. Then I said, I want to change young people too. That's the only reason today I actually canceled all my tickets to overseas, and I came, I said I'll fly tomorrow, because I said that if I can come here and say 5 things to you, and out of one, so many of you all, if I can change one person's life, I'm very sure that God will add more credits into my system. You know? Regardless if you're a Buddhist, Hindu or what, God is super, you know, right now. You know? He has all these banks and ATM machines. You pray for me, automatically you transfer. You know? That's how it works. Am I right now? So, the fifth one I want to tell you is, an organization that you build could be 2 people, could be 5 people, could be 100 people, or eventually at Masterskill, we started with 2, we have 1,400 people. All right. You can have entire 99% of my staff, faculty members, minimum degree. Now you've got PhD, you've got professors, you've got Dato professors, all. No? The challenge is, how could Edmund go and tell these professors who've been many years there? And also they are my Sifu and my Sikong, you know why not? They taught me when I was in UKM. My wife chancellor is from, she was my lecturer, she taught me marketing. I still remember she taught me CD1012. Asas Pengurusan Pemasaran. I remember all my code. So after the 6 crews, it makes me to realign, think a lot of things differently, you know. And you do the least. So, how do you do? So as an entrepreneur, I think the last one is money, fame and everything is one side. Money, power and status is one side that you were aiming for, but I think education is equally very important. And that's where, despite my after my first journalism, I got my MBA in 1998, University of Strathclyde. I did part-time, my own money. All my friends took the money when they were working as executive. They bought some nice Alfa Romeos and they parked in Bangsa and they enjoyed, while I bought a Proton Saga and I paid my money for Bank Raya. 44,000 12% interest, because I'm a non-boomy and therefore the interest rate is higher. Ali, yeah? But I took it, thank you to the bank, because they gave it to me. I got my MBA. Then I did my part-time BBA. My DBA, I only completed after brain aneurysm. You know, during my brain aneurysm, I sat there and did my DBA dissertation. Because before that, 3.5 years, I completed my thought module. And then I got the paper published. And this year, April, I graduated. That's why I got DR. This DR, not people simply give me one. So otherwise, people say, I notice a lot of people higher education, they award themselves. Professor emeritus, doctor, professor, I'm not like that. I'm a guy who respect education a lot. Then I told myself, and this lawyer forum keep on saying this Edmund got brain cancer, he's going to die, never invest, everything. So in order to convince me, not to convince them, I enrolled in INSEAD. INSEAD number 4 in the world, and I'm completing my executive master's degree, second postgraduate, on top of my doctorate. It's called as EdChem, Executive Master's Degree, Clinical Approaches to Management. So I said, now at least let me understand people. I become a clinical psychologist. Worst come to worst, if I really fail and so on, I want to become a politician, if people don't allow me, am I right or not? Then at least I become a clinical psychologist. And politicians, they lose. I need to sit with them and tell them and so on. I'm not trying to say that's why there's a lot of people in, outside there. So these five things when you put together, so when you have education, people respect you. It depends on what business that you are in. But eventually, when you put all this together, eventually when people say entrepreneur is all about leadership. If you are able to lead a group of people and manage the resource that you have effectively and efficiently, whatever business that you do, you would make it. Alright? But the question here is how big it is. How long does it take? How many times that you fall? Whether you are able to heal yourself or not. So going back into here, just to conclude, last 1 minute, since the Deputy Minister is here, his show is not mine. Winning awards is nice, alright? But now I don't participate in awards, anything at all, just because my daughter gets very upset every time I win. She said that I am paying to win. So even though I win, she will accuse me. So I told my daughter I'm not going to participate anymore award, because she got very frustrated because she's competing with me. So I cannot be competing with 11-year-old, am I right? So I told my daughter I'm not going to win, bring back any awards. So even I get awards right now, I put in the office and I never take it back home. Right? So collecting award is great, but eventually the best award that you get is build your business successfully, run your family perfectly, and then eventually the extra money that you have, instead of, if once a while, then instead of flying a business class, you can fly economy, the extra money that you get, you can help somebody do that. So eventually, this is, I think, in every religion, there is, in Hinduism, the Dharmashana, 10%. In the Christianity, there's also fasting. Even in Islam, the month of Ramadan and so on, they do a lot of good deeds and so on. So eventually, all these, God takes into calculation. Nowadays, you use supercomputer very fast, and when you got hit, then it comes and tell you, no, you're not ready yet. Likewise, when I won all this award, TOYP and everything, and I achieved before 40 everything I could achieve, I thought I'm the greatest in the world. And God gives the phone call and he says, no, Edmund, you're not. I decide which nerve in your brain and when, otherwise you behave and you do good things. So eventually when you become entrepreneur, CYEA is great, winning is great, doing is great, alright? The moral of the game is do good things to others. Thank you.